everyone. Genesis Writer here with a first video episode of my throwback film series where I go back before the Master Chief Collection comes out on November 11th, less than a month away, and I look through some of my old Halo Reach and Halo 3 films with you guys. This one happens to be a gameplay of Anniversary Team Slayer on the DLC map Ridgeline. Many of you may not recognize this map because it was part of the Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary DLC package. Do not be fooled by the Chris double kill you just saw. I was really a noob with a lot of my Halo Reach gameplay, as I'll describe later on in the film. But during this film, this is gameplay with a three-shot pistol. We have no sprint, three-shot pistol, improved Spartan speed settings. So this is really throwing back to some of the old Halo Combat Evolved settings, but in a more advanced and modern Halo Reach. I do get quite a few kills and some pretty decent multi-kills as well, and I want to talk a little bit about the Master Chief Collection and something I'm looking forward to in it, namely this map. And some of you may be going, wait, Halo Reach is not in the Master Chief Collection, and that is correct. Halo 3 ODST and Halo Reach currently do not have any plans to be in the Master Chief Collection. It is only Halo Combat Evolved, Anniversary, Halo 2, Anniversary, and Halo 3 and 4. Now, what I want to mention here, though, is that the current map you're seeing me play on, Ridgeline, as it is called in Halo Reach, is actually a remake from a map from Halo Combat Evolved called Timberland. Now, many of you may be going, wait, I didn't see this map in Halo Combat Evolved on my Xbox, and that would be correct, because Halo Combat Evolved on the Xbox did not have this map. This map was one of six exclusive, rather big maps to the Halo Combat Evolved PC and Mac versions. Those six maps are Death Island, Danger Canyon, Infinity, Timberland, obviously, Ice Fields, and Gyrophobia. Gyrophobia was later remade into Narrows in Halo 3. Now, one of the reasons I'm so excited for this is because the Master Chief Collection is going to have these previously exclusive to computer maps in the Halo Combat Evolved multiplayer. So you're going to get to play the original version of this map, Timberland, in Halo the Master Chief Collection multiplayer on November 11, 2014. You can actually pre-order the game right now on your Xbox One console so that as soon as the game becomes available to download, you can pre-download it so that as soon as the game releases, you can immediately play it, so you don't have to wait to download that disc if you buy the physical copy. Even with the limited or legendary version of Halo, the Master Chief Collection, I won't be getting that because I really want to have the digital copy so I can switch to it at any time and, you know, not have to worry with the disc. But kind of going back to this gameplay, some of you may be wondering, why am I using the DMR if I'm on three-shot pistol settings? These settings, the Anniversary Team Slayer, what that means also is that the pistol is a three-shot kill. Well, now, on Big Team Battle maps, the DMR is actually pretty powerful in Anniversary. I'm not sure if it's a three-shot kill, but it is pretty good when it comes to killing people at range. And I just like it a lot, and I often end up picking up some other weapon besides a pistol. That's why you're not going to see a whole lot of three-shot pistol kills in this gameplay, if any. So the gameplay kind of slows down here just a little bit for a minute. I'm actually playing with Leonard Church and Joker's Wild. Those are the only two tags I recognize from this film. I end up getting four triple kills during this gameplay, and so that's one of the reasons I wanted to upload it, was because it was a pretty interesting film to watch. Now, for those of you who don't know, Ridgeline and Timberland have two camos, or camo power-ups, on the left and right side of the map, and one single overshield ability that spawns in the bottom center portion of the map. So you can see overshield right here, the camo power-up spawns over here on this side, and a camo power-up spawns over here on this side. That's why you were seeing some of those shimmery players earlier on. They were not using the camo armor ability, because there's no armor abilities in Anniversary Team Slayer, thank goodness, because those make the game dramatically unfair if you're trying to be competitive and going for that sort of thing. But that's just my opinion. Also, there's health packs over here, as you can see. I'm kind of pushing up on this side. There's a shotgun over here as well. So there's a lot of really cool stuff. And the map is this is a more of a remix of the map from Halo Combat Evolved Ridgeline. This map that you're seeing right now, it takes the ideas from Halo Combat Evolved, involves Timberland, and sort of remixes them and makes it into its own map. And the results were really, really cool and satisfying, because Timberland and Halo Combat Evolved, from what I'm seeing and reading and watching in terms of gameplay, it was a pretty symmetrical big team battle map, and it provided not only good vehicle gameplay, but also on foot gameplay and cover from a lot of vehicles. And so it's really cool, really nice to see a map like that, and I cannot wait to play some of these maps. I also can't wait to play some of the Halo 2 PC-exclusive maps. Those are also really big in the Master Chief Collection. Now, right here, you may be wondering, what's that flame below me? Well, whenever you are on a spree and Halo reaches Anniversary Team Slayer or Anniversary Playlist, whenever you're on a spree, you would have Flaming Footsteps, which was pretty interesting. It added kind of a unique concept to the game. I liked it to some degree, but I think it was kind of unnecessary. I like also the anniversary because the bloom on your DMR and pistol are much more reduced. Bloom is where you're spamming the trigger and your reticle blooms bigger and bigger, making your shots less and less accurate. With the first two or three shots, you're really not going to notice it. But that's what TU means. If you guys are wondering, in Halo Reach, it means title update. 80% bloom settings, which is nice. Much better than the normal Team Slayer settings. That's probably one of the reasons I played so much Big Team Battle in Halo Reach, was because you always started with the DMR, and Big Team Battle was very quickly updated when TU updated settings came out. All of Big Team Battle was title updated settings, which is really nice. I really enjoyed that. Not only because you started with TMR and you didn't have to run around searching for one like you do in some Team Slayer, but you can just go for it. And that's really cool. One of the reasons I upload this gameplay also is because the two players you see missing from our two teams, those are the only players who quit throughout this entire game, which is nice. I felt like this game was a little more exciting than a lot of other films I have. I am really kind of disappointed with some of my other Halo Reach gameplays. Halo Reach is where I started getting good and understanding team characteristics. Now here, Joker's Wild is really struggling on the settings. You can see he only has 4 kills on the bottom of my team there, so I'm going to try to help him out, help him get some kills in this Warthog. Just wanted to commentate over that. But back to some of my Halo Reach films and clips. In this series, this throwback series where I take a look at some of my Halo Reach and Halo 3 films, I want to warn you guys that the gameplay is not going to be that impressive or that fantastic. And some of the films may be far less interesting than this one because they're not on DLC maps with settings you probably haven't seen before. They're actually pretty generic stuff. I played a decent amount of SWAT, for example, in Halo Reach. And I'm going to try to make this series as interesting as possible. But what I was going to mention is that I have at least 6 to 8 perfections saved in my theater, and none of them are worth uploading. And why I'm saying that is because there's guest players, people quit, I'm facing people who are garbage, my teammates are pretty decent, and literally I hang back with a sniper rifle the entire game. Even gameplays where I get 30 kills or 40 kills and no deaths are just simply not impressive and really boring to watch because I'm hanging out on the ridge on Hemorrhage, and to be honest, that's Hemorrhage is where I got most of my perfections sniping-wise. I really didn't use the camo very much at all, the armor ability camo. I first tried it out, and it was useful to some degree, but I like the power-up that you can see me using here much better than the armor ability, and I love the fact that you can sprint in Big Team Battle and Halo Reach, and that you can't necessarily spam the DMR long range. I felt like Bloom worked really well in SWAT. That's why SWAT was not updated to title update settings. There's still 100% bloom in SWAT, which means that if you spam the trigger more than 4 or 5 shots, your shots are going to be super inaccurate, which is the way really it should be in SWAT. I really like that aspect because it does make your shots count and be more accurate. But coming back to this gameplay, you can see that I'm finding some AFK players off to the side with only 11 kills remaining in this game. And I hope you guys are going to enjoy this series. I've really enjoyed going back and recording a lot of my films and especially all my clips. A lot of them are noobish and silly, and So I've kind of taken some out and edited and deleted some, but I'm hoping that some of my videos are going to interest you. For example, I'll have an other video where I go over various funny and random clips from Halo Reach. I'll have some of my firefight moments, some crazy moments from that. I'll compile all my SWAT clips from Halo 3, Halo Reach, and Halo 4, hopefully into one video. And the video I'm most excited about is my best clips from Halo 3 and Halo Reach, which, while they're not that impressive, I don't even think I get above a Killtacular in any of them. But they were really special to me because I remember a lot of my memories from them, and I spent a lot of time naming them and even describing them. So guys, thank you for watching this video. I hope you guys are going to enjoy this series a lot. I know I've had a lot of fun making even just this video and going through and seeing some of this old gameplay. Leave a like, subscribe for more Halo Master Chief Collection, Halo 5 Guardians content, and other Halo content in the future. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next capture or whatever end up recording. Peace.